So in the theory lecture, we have discussed about the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, Stefan-Boltzmann law, and now we are going to conduct the Stefan-Boltzmann experiment. So this is the setup where it is called as Stefan-Boltzmann apparatus. Now you can see this is the control panel of this Stefan-Boltzmann apparatus where you can observe these temperature indicators where we can observe the temperatures 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are four temperatures in this hemisphere and the fifth temperature is of the black plate. So you can also observe the temperature of this heater where this arrangement is there. Now this is the heater button, main switch, on off button and buzzer button. Now I will explain why it is required. Before that, we should observe this practical setup. Here it is a water tank in which heater is provided. And you can also observe this connection where this water tank is connected with the hemisphere, and this hemisphere is also having this level indicator. So you can understand what is the level of the water in this hemisphere, right? At the bottom of the side, here you can observe this arrangement, that is to measure the temperature of a black plate, that is the main temperature. So you can understand this black plate, you can observe this black plate, which is a simple metallic plate blackened by the lamp black, which is having near about 96% of the absorption. That is why we are using lamp black. Now this lamp black blackened plate is to be inserted in this hole so that we can measure the temperature of this hemisphere indirectly. So here indirect contact is maintained, and this is the drain wall arrangement. So after completing this experiment, we can on this wall, now it should be off before starting the experiment. This wall also should be off before starting the experiment because we are now heating the water which is inside the water tank, right? Now the temperature of this water is near about 55.8 degrees Celsius, which is sufficient temperature to heat that black plate. Now our main aim is to calculate the Stefan-Boltzmann constant. And now we know that the Stefan-Boltzmann law is that the rate of heat transfer is proportional to the absolute temperature raised to 4, right? And with the help of some constant, that proportionality is converted into equal sign with the help of that constant, and that is called as Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Now there is one parameter, that is emissivity, is also incorporated in that equation. So the main requirement is the temperatures. So on the basis of that temperature, we can calculate the Stefan-Boltzmann constant. Now this buzzer is provided. This buzzer is provided for measuring the temperatures, right? So when this main water is heated up to a certain temperature, then we can on this wall so that this water can flow inside the hemisphere. But before starting this wall, you should observe that this drain wall should be off. Then now this water is flowing from this water tank to the hemisphere, and after reaching a particular level, you can understand this level of the water tank with the help of this level indicator, right? Now After this, you have to put this black plate inside the apparatus. I think you have observed this, right? So this is the locking arrangement is provided in this stage. So this black plate can absorb the heat which is present with the water in the hemisphere, right? What does it mean now? We have heated this water in this tank. Now we are provided this heated water in the hemisphere, and now we are measuring the temperature of the black plate indirectly, that is through the heated water which is present in the hemisphere. Now, after the steady state temperature, after a particular time, you can on this buzzer, right? So you can observe these numbers. Now it is 6, it means it is T6, the temperature of the heated water. Now this is 5, it is 27.8, like this. T4, T3, T2 and T1. So you can observe the different temperatures of the hemisphere. Suppose if I on this buzzer, now the temperature 1, that is T1. So it is 56.3. Then second temperature, 56.3. Third buzzer, third temperature, T3, 56.8. Fourth buzzer, fourth temperature, T4, 56.5. T5, 28.7. Like this, you can take the number of readings for this T1 to T5 temperatures. On the basis of these temperatures, you have to calculate the Stefan-Boltzmann constant. We will observe the temperature first, we will record these temperatures, and then we will check how to calculate the Stefan-Boltzmann constant with the help of these temperatures. Now you can observe that the temperature of the black plate is increasing. It means the heat is gaining by the black plate through this heated water which is present in the hemisphere. So likewise, you can observe and record the different temperatures of a black plate and the other temperatures for the hemisphere. So we have to record T1 to T5 temperatures, and now we will record all these temperatures and we will check how to calculate this Stefan-Boltzmann constant with the help of this temperature.